Well, and we are continuing to follow that breaking news in Denver. We've confirmed that an officer is in the hospital after being shot and that the suspect is dead. It happened earlier this morning.
Yeah, that section of Zoo and I, Drew, just talked about right off of I-25 and Spear Boulevard. Fox 31's Lisa D'Souza is at the scene. She joins us now. And Lisa, I know you heard from the chief a bit ago. He said this road would be closed for a couple of hours as that investigation continues. The suspect killed in this situation. So what happened? What a bizarre situation it sounds like.
A terrifying situation, no doubt about that. And I should note that the police chief was visibly emotional when we talked to him here this morning. So this all seems to be a random act of violence against a police officer. According to this latest update from Denver Police, you can see this police car here in front of the Quality Inn has a few bullet holes there on one side from our vantage point. And obviously you can see all of these evidence markers as well. So the details of what happened here, according two officials we spoke with this morning, right around 4:15, a man walked by that patrol car you're looking at right now, walked into the hotel, came back out a few minutes later, pulled out a gun and shot at the police officer in the driver's seat at least three times. That suspect shooting through the passenger and driver's side. We know the officer was hit once in the chest and twice in the back. He was wearing a bulletproof vest that saved his life, according to officials. You can imagine that officer, just a terrifying situation unfolding here. We're told that officer was able to crawl out the side of the car, call for help. Police arrived, and then at some point, of course, gunfire was exchanged with the suspect. That suspect killed in that exchange. Again, the bulletproof vest here saving that officer's life ultimately. And again, Police Chief Ron Thomas, as you can imagine, visibly emotional when we talked to him this morning. He had just come from visiting that officer in the hospital. Take a listen.
We all recognize that we face those challenges every day. We take this job to support and protect our community, and so we're proud to do that job. And I'm proud of that officer who acted very quickly, and I think probably protected this community from a very dangerous individual.
And he said he is going to continue to encourage officers to wear their police vest. You can imagine what an emotional day this really is for members of the DPD community right now, thinking of one of their own. So as far as that officer goes, we know that he is in his 40s. He's been with the force anywhere from 10 to 15 years. The suspect, officials say they believe, is in his 30s. And again, the details of why this happened still unclear. Police say they don't believe that that officer and the suspect exchanged any words or had any sort of interaction before this shooting ultimately played out. Now, we know that the officer in the hospital right now is up and talking with his family at the hospital right now. Again, does not have life-threatening injuries, expected to be completely okay, all thanks to that bulletproof vest. It's unknown if the suspect was potentially staying at this hotel. Police say it's possible that he went in to ask about a room before coming out and again shooting at that officer inside the patrol car you're looking at right now. So obviously investigators are on scene from police, homicide, CSP, other agencies as well. And just looking at this scene from this vantage point, it's easy to understand why this area is going to be roped off for several more hours here. Certainly a scary, scary situation, no doubt about that. Again, this is just right off of Spear and Zudai. So if you're driving past this area, you can expect this stretch to be roped off for quite some while as this investigation continues. For now, we are live at 26 in Zuni. Lisa D'Souza, Fox 31.
As they take pictures of the bullet holes in the police officer's car right there behind you. Hey, Lisa, a question for you. You know, a hotel like that typically would have cameras outside. A lot of businesses in the area might have cameras outside. Have police said if they have any video of what went down here?
At this point, not too sure about that. You can imagine, though, this Quality Inn, obviously, you know, the Quality Inn's a chain. You can imagine that right. They probably do have cameras, and if that's the case, they'll be, you know, combing through that video. We also know right on the other side of this Quality Inn is a Shell gas station as well. Gas stations typically have that surveillance video.
Right. Yeah, definitely a busy part of town.
Something we'll be watching.
And a busy morning. Mm-hmm. All right, Lisa, thank you.